Good evening. South Australia has reopened to much of the country, with border restrictions easing with the Northern Territory, Western Australia and parts of Queensland. New South Wales is still barred as Sydney's COVID outbreak grows, but the relaxation of rules here was welcomed by travellers who no longer need to quarantine.
Bags packed, these holiday makers are off to Cairns.
Queensland's such a big state, I think open it up and let's go on holiday.
Oh, I'm pretty happy with that. That's great, because I'm visiting my mum.
South Australians delivered some good news in the midst of school holidays as the isolation state opens back up.
Should have been home last Wednesday, but circumstances arise, that's what happens.
It's not easy isolating with kids, no. So happy to be home.
These border closures, we know that they have been very difficult, especially around this school holidays, but they have been necessary to keep our state safe.
Travellers from the Northern Territory and Western Australia are now allowed back in, but they'll still need to be tested and isolate until their first negative result.
From Sunday, we envisage that this will be removed completely and there'll be no testing requirement.
All restrictions have been lifted with most parts of Queensland. Townsville and attendees of the Big Red Bash at Birdsville just required testing. But much of the southeast remains locked out, including Noosa, Sunshine Coast, Gold Coast and Brisbane, as does New South Wales and the ACT.
We know that there's a very porous border. We know that there are more than 10,000 people currently home, not out in the local area because they have been into New South Wales.
Noel Harradine's been in quarantine since Monday after flying in from Cairns. These changes mean he's free to go.
I was a lot happier. A lot happier. Happy little Vegemite, I'd say. So I'm planning on going over to the pub tonight to have a beer, to be honest with you.
There's a smaller group of people that will require to continue their quarantine, and those are people who have been identified as being actually at an exposure site in any of those states.
South Australians are being reminded to be flexible, warned there are still risks when travelling interstate.
My sister's in Darwin, but we just never thought, like, NT hadn't been in a lockdown like that before, so I thought I was pretty safe going over there.
All travellers arriving here at Adelaide Airport will need to fill out a cross-border declaration before they are arriving to ensure they have not visited any barred locations. Now, the Police Commissioner says that there will be a big police presence still at the airport to ensure all those arriving are permitted to be let in. Kate?
Ollie, thank you.